figure out what door this key opens. It has to be somewhere around the temple. Oh, you're right. Now that we've got the key, we can open that big door anytime we want. Let's explore.
For those Nephilim runes. And the travel rune is here too. You wanna go? want to see what we can trade those for? Another name. Rolta!
Another Valkyrie. That's no coincidence. But who'd have etched them on Tyr's braziers?
Can you read it?
Sir. Oh yeah, I can translate this now. Niflheim, land of fog and fortune. Hey, nobody mentioned fortune. We should go there sometime.
This'll be our best work yet. We need a little help from you lot.
I'm confused. I always heard that Baldur's mother was Frigg.
Aye, Frigg. Well, that's more of a pet name, you see. It means beloved, something Odin called Freya after they wed. Out of affection at first, or so I like to believe. As things turned sour, it became a way to manipulate the truth.
How so?
Odin didn't want Freya, a Vanir goddess, getting credit for anything in Asgard. So anything worthy she accomplished was attributed to Frigg.
Like being Baldur's
mother. That's right. Freya was Baldur's mother all along.
Another name. Ulrich.
It's as if they've been made into a memorial to the Valkyries.
I'm glad Brock and Sindri were able to work out their differences.
Now they are twice as irritating.
Ah, I think it's nice to see them trust each other again. Mimir, you never told us what Magni and Modi had to do with Hrungnir.
Oh, yes! Well, what happened after Hrungnir fell slain upon Thor was that nobody in the court could get the stone body off of him. Thor was no use at this point. His brain rattled, his breath shallow. But none of Odin's men were nearly strong enough to help. Then enter little Magni and Modi, no taller than shrubs. And while nobody but myself was looking, they flipped over Hrungnir's corpse and freed their father. Magni, being blonder, got all the credit, and Modi remained bitter about it from that day to the end, which I don't need to tell you about.
Huh? reach over here. To the city.
I'm not entirely sure, lad. It was abandoned long before Jormungandr came to town and flooded the place.
I wonder what it was like to live here.
Follow me, Atreus.
On my way.
Yeah! think this is something.
Yeah.
Focus up! Atreus, follow me.
Why did you work for Odin if he's so horrible?
It's my career! And if you mean to make your career as a counselor to kings, it can't very well be like petty maniacs. Available positions are scarce enough. My first master was a cruel piece of work as well, but I learned through him the enduring power of wit, which served me well with kings and gods alike. I couldn't have been much older than you when I started. A fairy king's errand boy and unofficial jester. By night, my mates and I had the run of the forest. Good fellows, they called us. Knavish spikes to the last. We'd get up to all manner of mischief, making fools of the local mortals. But as long as our lord was kept amused, we were spared the consequences. Then one day he was not amused, and I saw fit to move on. Thankfully, the ages and roads travelled since then have turned me from that merry wanderer into the paragon of virtue you see before you today.
Should we dock on this beach?